观众朋友大家好，今天我们很荣幸的请到了犹他州众议会34选区的关玉莲女士来我们 studio 接受 UCCTV 新闻报道的专访。下面我们就请关玉莲女士跟我们谈谈她竞选的一些问题和看法。Welcome and thank you for taking the time and answer some questions we have.
Thank you.
Karen, you are the professor of psychology at Tholick Community College, and you have a beautiful family and three lovely daughters. So why you want to run public office?
That's a good question. It does take a lot of time and a lot of effort and energy. So the support of my family and friends is foremost. It's very important.But what is also important is that we have a voice in the Utah legislature in a way that we haven't had before. Asian Americans are often ignored in politics, and we're seen as not maybe a group that really has issues that need to be addressed. And that's not true. We all have these issues that we should have our governments address.And so I want to make sure that we're able to have a voice.
You are very active in politics in Utah, and you have been like service community for many, many, many years. And you have been like active in Chinese, Asian, and Pacific Islander organizations and served the community. But some people in the Chinese community may not still know you well.So could you tell us more about your campaign platform and what you're running on?
Yes, absolutely. Thank you for that question. I am running on making sure that our Utah families have a healthy and well-being. So I'm very interested in making sure that our families have access to education and access to clean air and health insurance.Making sure that our families have economic development. So I'm looking at that health and well-being of our families.
So Karen, there never have been a Chinese American elected to the state office in Utah. If you got elected, you will be the first. And never to say that you will be the first woman Chinese American elected in state of Utah. So what your campaign can benefit Chinese American society as a whole?
Well, you know, I think that it's very important for us to be represented, and it is important and an honor and a privilege to be the first to run and also to be the first to serve, the first Chinese American woman to serve in the Utah legislature. I think it's very important because.For the Chinese community, estimates say we're about 25,000 to 40,000 Chinese Americans here in Utah. That's the largest Asian ethnic group here. We also are the very first ethnic group that came into Utah back in the mid-1800s. And to not have a voice on the Hill says that it's time for us to do that.We want to make sure that first and foremost, now this is not something that is one of my issues, but it certainly is an important part of our Chinese community to have Lunar New Year recognized. Now, to my knowledge, we never have had it recognized on the floor. And that just is one thing to bring into Utah politics to make sure that our holidays,and our values are represented. Now, there are other issues within the Utah politics that our Chinese community is very interested in making sure that it is represented well. One issue could be the acupuncture license.
That's true.
Now, that is something that's coming up in 2017. We want to make sure that that license is renewed.Another one that is very important to our community is immigration reform. Mm-hmm. Now, while that is something that is on the national level, it certainly impacts us here. Not only with the Chinese Americans and family reunification, we see this in other communities as well, other Asian communities. Our Filipino community here in Utah has estimated that 70% of their community members, of our community members right here in Utah, have a family member that they've been waiting on for a decade or more. These are people who have, in fact, gone through the proper channels, are legally ready and can come to America, and they're waiting on their backlog of visas. So in our community, we do have specific issues that is very important to have a voice in. And may not be seen as an Asian issue, may be seen as something that is for other communities. Now, you know that the Chinese Exclusion Act of 1882 prevented Chinese Americans from becoming citizens. And in fact, for 10 years, we had deported Chinese Americans. This is in 1882. This wasn't repealed until much later, in the mid-1900s. It didn't impact the whole of America. Well, Chinese Americans, we've been here for many decades, and we are part of the whole of America. And so that's why it's very important for me to make sure that we're well represented.
Great. Glad you mentioned that acupuncture in your talk. The old campaign slogan, it's called "Where's the Beef?" So let's talk about beef. So let's just pick one subject because there are many small and medium businesses in the Chinese community. And they are struggle every day to serve the community, everyone, not just Chinese people. What you can do as an elected office, a state office, help them prosper and to be more contributing to the community?
Absolutely. When I grew up, my dad had a restaurant, a tiny little hole in the wall that was a takeout restaurant. And I worked in that restaurant since the time I can walk, you know, helping my dad box little cookies or place the soy sauce into the packages, into the bags. So I understand the struggles of small business. And I think that when I talk to other small business owners, the thing that I hear is taxes, taxes, taxes. There's so many taxes that are placed on, and the burden is on the small businesses, because small businesses cannot afford, like big business, they cannot afford lawyers to represent them. They cannot afford to leave their businesses to go lobby on the Hill. This is one thing that I'm very interested in, to make sure that access to finances is easy for our small business owners so that they can get the resources that they need, and also to watch over that there's not undue taxes, that there's not an undue burden in comparison to other businesses.
您现在收看的是 UCCTV 犹他中文电视台。
我是于小如，纽约人寿保险公司犹他分公司的业务代表。纽约人寿保险公司是美国最大的也是历史最悠久的互惠人寿保险公司之一。纽约人寿保险公司在全美各州均有分公司，可及时为您提供周到的服务。
保护您最关切的是我们共同的目的，请与我联系，让我来帮助您使美好的生活长存。
UCCTV 犹他中文电视台将与东方报联合举办犹他第一届金曲歌唱大赛，我们欢迎14岁以上的中外人士踊跃参与，热烈响应。您可拨打报名专线8019285588 8019285588。UCCTV 犹他中文电视台官方网站及官方 Facebook 线上报名与洽询，3月15日起可至各大 KTV 餐厅索取报名表。比赛日期为5月7日、5月14日星期六的两场初赛，5月21日星期六的复赛，5月28日星期六的决赛及冠军赛。我们也欢迎观众朋友们到现场为参赛者加油，详细地址请参考 UCCTV 官方网站。本次比赛有着丰厼的奖金奖品，第一名奖金3000元及价值5000元以上的礼券礼品，第二名奖金2000元及价值3000元以上的礼券礼品，第三名奖金1000元及价值1500元以上的礼券礼品，第四名至第十名均可得到价值1000元以上的礼券礼品。详情请洽询 UCCTV 中文电视台金曲歌唱大赛节目组。
达人你在哪儿？
达人你在哪儿？
达人你到底在哪儿？
UCC TV 由他中文电视台即将推出崭新的节目达人你在哪儿。
不管你是会制作美食垂钓还是摄影，
或你有家传秘方独门绝技，
都欢迎你们到节目中与我们分享，
请与我们联络 UCC TV 由他中文电视台
达人你在哪儿。
您现在收看的是 UCC TV 由他中文电视台。
Let's switch the topic a little bit. Last year, 2 years ago, actually, you ran the race a little bit late, and you ran against an incumbent, which have much more campaign money than you have.
Yes.
But you run a successful campaign, and finally, you come just 200 votes short to get elected. So this year, and you are more excited and more energized.So how is the campaign this year different from last time?
Well, I think that having a session behind me, having a season of campaigning, helps me to understand how to campaign better. Mm-hmm. But more importantly, what it did was told me that, as we've all known, District 34 is a Democratic district.But also more participation from Asian and Pacific Islanders, and the Chinese community has been amazing. Not only Democrats, but Republicans as well. And I like to see that. I like to see our communities getting involved. You know, education is a huge issue for us.
Right.
We want to make sure that our kids have access to education. I want to make sure thatall kids, all students have access to education. I work at Salt Lake Community College, and we just put together this fantastic program. It's called the Promise Scholarship. Have you heard of this?
No, actually not.
So Salt Lake Community College has the Promise Scholarship, which allows any Utah resident who comes into Salt Lake Community College will give a tuition-free scholarship. So whatever is remaining from their tuition, Salt Lake Community College will pay for that.
Great.
Now, there are certain qualifications, of course, but this opens it up to a wider number of people. I'd like to see community college be free for all of our students, for all of our kids, because education is important. We know thatThe Chinese American community actually is doing very well with our kids and going to education, but other Asian and Pacific Islander groups don't do quite as well. So this energy that I have is this feeling that I can make a change. I can make a change with the help of the Chinese community, and we can do it for us, for our families, for our kids.
Right.
That's the energy that I have.
Great. I'm sure that many people from Chinese community are very excited, but on the other hand, they are very new to the politics and the campaign especially. Could you tell our audience, say, what they can do and how they can get involved?
Yes, absolutely. You know, last time when we ran, we saw more Chinese Americans and Asian and Pacific Islanders than we ever have in the process. And this is so exciting. So we can continue to do the things that we did last time, knocking on doors and making phone calls and standing on street corners with our sign and asking for people to honk their horn just to get our name out there. And they can also very easily...go online and go to my website, www.votekarenkwan.com. They can donate to the campaign. This is very much appreciated, very much needed. They can look for some of the activities that we're going to be doing in the future, and they can sign up right there and get on an email list so that they can follow along. They can go on Facebook, on Twitter, Instagram, and they can follow along our campaign.Right then. But let me put one more push out there. Donations can come from anywhere. It can come from other states, and in fact, we do have support from other states. It can come internationally. And in fact, I have had some donations from our supporters in China. I still have family in China. And so donations can come online, and it's a very easy thing to do. So I very much appreciate the Chinese community as being the base of my campaign for the last 2 years.
Great. Last week, and you had a very successful kickoff party, and many people showed up in support of your campaign. And what's your plan for next? And what are you going to do next?
Well, you know, I actually see this more as our campaign, right? This is, and it was a fun party, and it was a great energizing event to get us ready to go out there and start meeting more people, knocking on doors and asking for their support. But what we're going to do next is voter registration. We saw a huge turnout in both the Republican and the Democratic neighborhood caucuses this time, more so than anybody can remember in the past. And so now what we need to make sure is that these people are registered and that they will vote. That's going to make the difference this time. So we're going to go out there. We're going to start making sure that we are doing voter registration. We're going to meet our voters, and we're going to start putting up campaign signs and asking people to support us, to donate to the campaign, and to join us. So I hope that the viewers out here are going to be able to come and join us on this campaign season.
今天非常感谢Karen Kwan 接受我们的专访，来介绍他的那个政见。但是我还有一个个人的问题想要问问 Karen。Karen。And you have a very lovely little daughter, and we saw her all over the campaign and in many parties. Can we have her come in and speak some words to our viewers?
Oh, absolutely.
Do you like to say some words?
Mm-hmm. 我的名字是李妹呀。Ken Kwan 是我的妈妈，我爱她很多。
Very good. Thank you very much, you and Karen. And thank you for your come to UCCTV and for the interview. And thank you for all these questions, answer all these questions for our viewers.
Well, thank you. It's my pleasure.
Thank you.